Oh, I think it's absolutely close in Maryland. And I also think that there's 18% of people undecided. And I think after Super Tuesday, we're going to see some of these candidates probably drop out who don't do as well as they hope.
And that is Goucher pollster Malia Cromer. Second part of the Goucher poll released today ahead of tonight's debate among the Democratic candidates in South Carolina in the South Carolina primary Saturday, Super Tuesday, 1 week from today, measuring how Marylanders and Maryland Democrats feel about the presidential candidates. C4 joins me now. So this is 371 likely Democratic voters, 24% for Bernie Sanders, 18% Joe Biden, 16% for Michael Bloomberg, margin of error 5.1%. So a slight lead for Sanders. C4, where do you see it?
Well, our poll here in Maryland is now beginning to mirror what United States Senator Bernie Sanders is doing nationally. There was a Morning Consult survey poll that came out that shows right now Bernie Sanders with a plurality lead nationally, which has not happened before. At least Joe Biden was ahead for the most part. So in other words, Maryland's Democrats are starting now to reflect what is happening in other states across the country with Senator Bernie Sanders.
So if not after Saturday night's primary, or certainly after Super Tuesday, do we see some of these moderate candidates dropping out?
You would think, wouldn't you?
You would think.
Usually after Iowa and New Hampshire, Robert, you see that. But we haven't seen it so far. They stayed around for Nevada. They're going to be on the ballot in South Carolina. Michael Bloomberg is on the ballot in any of these. He's on the ballot Super Tuesday, March the 3rd. So all these dynamics are kind of, they're breaking rules that we haven't seen before, unwritten rules as they may be, that we haven't seen before. But I do see Elizabeth Warren staying. I don't see her leaving, even though people have said she might have problems raising money. I don't see Joe Biden leaving, even though if he loses, which right now he's leading in South Carolina.
Or it's too close in South Carolina.
He's not leaving. So who's actually leaving, I guess, Robert, is the question, in order to get down to the few candidates left.
All right, Mayor Pete, Amy Klobuchar still staying in the race.
Correct.
I want to turn to the mayor's race, and there is a poll out. It was actually conducted for Brandon Scott's campaign. The results were obtained by Baltimore Brew.
Yep.
And it shows Sheila Dixon with a 20%, taking 20% of the vote with the lead. Brandon Scott in second place, 16%. Margin of error is 4.9%. So that's within the margin of error. TJ Smith, 13%. Mayor Jack Young, Tharoor Vittaraja, tied at 11%.
Two things in that. The violence in Baltimore City, I said from the very beginning, if Jack Young were to run for mayor, because initially, remember, he wasn't running for mayor. He was just caretaking the position, at least he said at the very beginning, once former mayor Catherine Pugh stepped down. But if he stayed as mayor, Robert, crime and violence would be tied to him. And if he didn't see a reduction, he would have problems. And we see it right now.
Right.
With the violence we've seen, I truly believe his 11% is reflected, even though he's kind of the incumbent by that. When you look at Tharoor Vittaraja, I believe his drop is directly related, if you want to look at the prior poll, to the video that was released with him and the police back in November of last year. But Sheila Dixon being there, a lot of people, Robert, are saying we know the baggage that she has, but we remember that crime got reduced when she was mayor. That's what I see.
What you know about the typical voter in Baltimore City, and it's tough for us to discuss it because it's African-American women over 45, might be mothers or grandmothers, might be single
voters.
Mothers or grandmothers. They may be raising grandchildren on their own. They may have some connection with a relative to the criminal justice system. A long time ago, when I was covering the Dixon trial, a very well-respected woman in my life and a very well-respected woman in this building told me that women are judgmental, and that's why women jurors voted to convict Sheila Dixon.
Right.
Have they forgiven Sheila Dixon 10 years later?
I think they have. I think that her contrite attitude and kind of weird, what the kind of road to redemption that she's been seeking, I think a lot of people are. When I talk to a lot of African-American women who are seasoned citizens, we call them now, Robert, they say that they believe that she's learned from her lessons and that they're willing to give her a second chance. But the Catherine Pugh situation is hanging there for a lot of voters, and they're not willing, I don't believe, a lot of voters, that's why that 20%, I believe, is where it is, to give her that chance because of Catherine Pugh's predicament that she's in right now.
All right, and don't forget, you can hear the presidential debate tonight on WBAL. Coverage starts at 7 o'clock, and C4 will talk about it tomorrow, 9 to 1,
Thanks,
on WBAL, News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.